Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's look at customizing your Mac using TinkerTool. So TinkerTool is a utility that you download online. Here's the URL to it, and you go to the download area, click the download button here, and it will give you a disk image. You put that in your application/utilities folder, and then you can run it. Now I can only recommend using TinkerTool if you're an advanced Mac user. This is going to give you the power to change how your Mac works, and it can be very dangerous if you don't know what you're doing. Now you know how every once in a while you see how you can change something on your Mac by typing in a long line in the terminal window. Type this long line and it changes how your Mac works, changes some sort of setting. Well, all TinkerTool is it's easy access to these. Instead of having to type this line in terminal, you can just check a box in TinkerTool. So it doesn't really do anything that you can't do without TinkerTool. It just makes it easier to find and change these settings. So when you run TinkerTool, you get a huge set here of different tabs at the top, different categories of settings. And you click on a tab like Finder here and you can see all the different things that you can change. Now note that in a lot of cases you need to relaunch whatever it is you're affecting. So for instance, I can change something here and I won't see the change until I relaunch the Finder, and usually there's a button there that makes it easy to do that. So for instance, I go to another set here. I can go to the Dock set here and there are different things I can do, but I have to relaunch Dock as well. So let's just as a test here try one of these. It's not a very useful one, but I'm going to turn on Disable Three-Dimensional Glass Effect. If I go down to my Dock, you can see it looks normal now. I do that and I relaunch the Dock, and now I go down to the Dock and it looks like this instead. So not too useful. A lot of these are just kind of cosmetic things, so you don't necessarily want to use all of these, but there are a few that are useful. Let me point some out. So I've just turned on Use Transparent Icons for Hidden Applications and I've relaunched the Dock. And what this does is it's kind of neat. Down here in the Dock now you can see TextEdit is semi-transparent there. And that's because I've hidden it. If I bring it to the front, it's a normal icon. I'm going to use Command H to hide it, and now you can see in the Dock it's hidden. So it kind of gives me a nice visual indicator of what I've hidden here, or what may actually just not have any windows open at the time. So here under General Settings, there are some useful things, but one I like is to turn on the expanded save dialogs when using new applications. I showed this in a recent episode. You can have the simplified save options or the expanded ones, and once you expand it remembers that, but this will turn it on by default, so the first time you use it it's always expanded. So you can see I have that one turned on. If you're using a Mac that has an optical drive, here's an option to add an eject button to the menu bar, and this will restart the menu bar here. If you need to access eject pretty often and you don't like moving over to the keyboard to do it, it's an easy way to do it right there. You can also completely deactivate dashboard here if you don't want to use that as well. Some of these you notice aren't just things that are in the terminal window, but actually things you can access in system preferences, but they're also here. The Applications tab has several different applications in it you can customize. For instance, one thing here is that in Mail you can set it so that attachments aren't displayed in the message. You have to actually open them up as you would have had to do years ago before they had inline attachments. Also you can turn on a lot of debug menus in different applications if you want to use those. And there's some useful things like under Spotlight not including dictionary entries in your searches. There's some handy ones in the QuickTime tab. One is here the appearance of the controls. Sometimes it's annoying every time you move your cursor to have those controls display. Sometimes you want to keep them always visible. So you can kind of customize that here using these settings. Now here's a very useful section under Resume. A lot of people like or hate the Resume feature, but you can turn it off. So that way when you quit an application it automatically closes all the windows when quitting the application. This is the default behavior, but then you can customize it per app. So for instance, if you wanted Pages to always close the windows when you quit and work differently than all your other apps, you can set it here to yes, always close windows when quit. So next time you start Pages, your documents will all be closed. Or you can set any of these to use the default. So TinkerTool, like the settings themselves, seems exciting when you first hear about it, but the changes are really quite minor and don't really affect that much. I find that I rarely ever change one of the default settings. So again, I would only recommend this for advanced users, and only if there's some setting that you really like that you find it easier to change this way rather than using the terminal window. Hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. Want more video tutorials? Just go to MacMost.com, click on the videos link at the top of the page, and then you can view all of the hundreds of MacMost videos by category.